Thank you so much. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Monsignor Brockman, and I serve as Vicar General of the Diocese of Raleigh, and I'm here to represent both Bishop Michael Burbidge, who's the Catholic Bishop of Raleigh, and Bishop Peter Jugas, who is the Catholic Bishop of Charlotte. A great opportunity to be with you here today and to really speak on behalf not only of the two bishops, but some 800,000 Catholics who reside in our great state, who we are speaking for as well. I want to thank our media as well for being present to address this issue, which is obviously very near and dear to our hearts, especially to our brothers and sisters in the North Carolina Latino Coalition, who are working so hard, as so many of our other speakers are as well, on this very important issue. And I know that all of our speakers today and in the session to follow will address in far greater detail part of the issues, as we just heard. But I want to address how the approach of our Catholic faith tradition approaches some of these common concerns to all of us. One of the most frequent questions we have to all of our Catholic Church leadership is, why are you involved in what would seem to be political issues? That's a common question, right? Well, our answer is really clear, and it's very simple, that for us as Catholics, we consider it an obligation to address public law and policy when those laws and policies have a moral perspective. And so to comment on laws and policies, those comments have to be seen through the lens of three basic questions that we have. Number one, are these laws and policies humane? Number two, do they serve the common good? Number three, and do they uphold the God-given right that we have to human dignity? So let me briefly, just very briefly, go over all of those. First, are the laws and policies humane? Our primary concern is to make sure that any proposed legislation or law safeguards the promotion and defense of basic human rights. We heard a little bit about that already. While legislation should serve and protect society, enforcement, which obviously we hear a lot about, that should not overshadow what is humane, such as families being able to stay together, as we just heard about, that people may live in our state in safety, and that all may have the proper due process protections that may be preserved, especially with regard to those who are detained, as we also just heard about. In essence, everybody here today, we need to understand that our laws also must be just and fair. So that's the first point. Second point is, do these laws and policies serve the common good of society? That's one of the primary purposes of government, right? In our Catholic understanding, we believe that government serves the common good of society. A prime example of serving that common good is one of the proposed bills that we've been hearing a lot about today. That's the House Bill 786. In providing a way for undocumented immigrants to have access to driver's licenses in our state, in effect, that availability is serving that common good by guaranteeing that people who receive and apply for these licenses may have studied our motor vehicle laws and have passed a test, thereby, of course, making our roads safer. That's something that serves the common good. Recently, both Bishop Jugas and Bishop Burbidge spoke on that issue, on the importance of providing our young people with driver's licenses, namely with respect to those who qualify for the federal government's Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program. And we joined together as Catholics with many others in applauding the decision by our North Carolina State Department of Transportation in granting that privilege to those who are truly seeking what they deserve, which is an education and a new way to make a contribution to the good of our society here in the state of North Carolina. And lastly, third point, in considering any existing law or proposed legislation, how does this law or policy uphold human dignity, which we believe as Catholics is given to us by Almighty God? Well, as Catholics, we believe that all people are created in the image and likeness of God and redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus. And so we believe then that we must respect and defend the inherent dignity given to every human person, including those who migrate to our great state and to our proud nation, and who have come in search of a better life for themselves and for their families. Important to note that as Catholics, we do believe that every country does have the right to secure its borders and establish policies for immigration. But we also believe that all countries are called to the higher obligation of providing avenues for people to enter their country legally. And so immigration, any of the reform must have that kind of comprehensive view. In our country, that requires reform, as we've heard about, because as we all know now, it isn't working. Specific details of the policies and procedures we all know need to be worked out, not only in our state, but also with our federal, on the federal level, and that we can reaffirm and begin to reform also those laws which need a lot of work. To sum up then, the time is now. We've certainly been talking about this need for reform for way too long, and we can't wait to reform a system that is broken, unjust, and unfair. And so, as this debate gets underway in earnest, as Catholics, and on behalf of both bishops, Catholic bishops of North Carolina, we call on all parties concerned, everybody who's working on this, to make the commitment to pursue this debate in a civil and respectful manner, one that's reflective of the goodness of our country and resisting any kind of labeling or demonizing of those who provide so courageously the labor for our economy and a decent living wage for their families. And so as we pursue this, let it be rather than labeling and anything that's destructive, a reflection of the great dignity that we know is given to every human being by the one who has created each and every one of us. Thank you so much.